Hi! In the previous video, you've learned how to use themes in Active Presenter. Today's video will show one of the design components in themes. That's theme fonts. Working with theme fonts is a good way to create a consistent look for your content in any project. So, watch the rest of this video to understand entirely about theme fonts in Active Presenter. Let's walk through four main parts in turn. Overview: apply and manage theme fonts, create new theme fonts, and modify theme fonts. Now, let's begin with the first one. As you may know, each set of theme fonts includes a heading font and a body font. The former is used for slide or question titles, while the latter is used for body text on slides. The body text can be the text that you type into text boxes, captions, buttons, shapes, or even the answer options in questions. What's more, access the Design tab and click Fonts to see the whole theme font gallery. Here, the currently used theme fonts are indicated by a gray outline. For each set of fonts listed, you'll see the name, the heading font, and the body font. There are three main sections in the theme font gallery. The custom one shows theme fonts you've created. Meanwhile, the built-in includes preset theme fonts that Active Presenter offers you. At the bottom of the gallery, the other section provides options to create and reset theme fonts. To see how theme fonts affect the look of your text, just hover the mouse over any set of theme fonts. You can directly click one, or right-click any set of theme fonts to have more options to apply fonts. This applies the theme fonts to all slides that use the same slide master as the current slide. You can select this option if you want to apply the theme fonts to currently selected slides only. In case the new theme fonts don't please you, click Reset Slide Theme Fonts to return the original theme fonts. Also, pick this option to apply these fonts to all slides in your working project. In case you right-click any set of the custom theme fonts, you will have two more options to work with them. Edit brings up the Theme Font Editor, where you can edit your fonts. Learn more about that in the next parts. If you no longer need any theme fonts, select this option to remove them from the theme font gallery. These two options are just available for custom theme fonts only. Now, it's time to explore the way to create new theme fonts. Let's click Create New Theme Fonts to open this pop-up dialog. It consists of the heading font and body font list, name box, and sample section. This previews the changes when you select different fonts in these two lists. Now, select another heading font and body font. Enter a new name if you want. Then click OK to finish. This set of new custom theme fonts will be available in any Active Presenter project you build. It's simple to go back and modify any custom theme fonts you've created. Just right-click your custom theme fonts and select Edit. The Edit Theme Fonts dialog appears, and you can do the same guidelines shown above to modify and save your fonts. So, that's all about working with theme fonts I want to share. Hope that it helps. See you.